dressed in black and ready to fight. This is what the world sees of the Antifa.
Oh, Nazis get smoked!
There is no national Antifa group. It is mostly made up of people who are far left of center, who make it their mission to battle fascists, racists, and alt-right extremists. Behind the masks are people from all walks of life, artists, moms, ordinary Americans, as well as anarchists. But fighting is only part of what the Antifa does.
So everybody had a good day at school today?
These Antifa members battle white supremacists using cameras and computers, outing neo-Nazis on social media in a process called doxing.
Yo, Tubbs! Tubbs, fat boy!
Jessica and Alex capture white supremacist rallies on video, then post identities of the participants online, outing them to their friends and co-workers.
What is doxing?
It's ascertaining an individual's identity and personal information, and then engineering social consequences for that person for being out in the streets as a white supremacist and making threats against minority communities. You do not get to be a Nazi on the weekend. If you're a Nazi on Saturday and you're marching with a torch, you're a Nazi all week long.
So you already know who he is. What's the point of taking this video?
His friends.
His friends.
Who have you doxed?
The most obviously high-profile one was Mr. Corey Clicco.
Corey Clicco was a member of the neo-Nazi political party called the National Socialist Movement. That is, until Jessica outed him in this story she posted online.
What happened immediately afterwards was he dismantled his chapter, he stopped organizing, he canceled his events, and he publicly disavowed Nazism, said he disavowed hate.
Clicco couldn't be reached for comment for this story.
We meet a lot of Antifa who are kind of on the fringes of society. You're really not.
No.
You have a job, middle management, right?
Yes.
You have a family.
Yes.
How do you go from being suburban mom to Nazi hunter?
I have a skill. I think I can leverage it to do this kind of work for my community. And it's fun. It's fun. It's a lot of fun.
This means Nazi go home. You got a problem with my sign.
I got a problem with you calling me a b-.
I wonder why you got a problem with my sign.
I got a problem with you calling me a b-, not your sign.
Doxing by both the alt-right and the Antifa is becoming more prevalent than the violence. But it's the violence that gets most of the attention.
I hung back to smoke a cigarette.
Alex has traveled by bus to a dozen protests across the country since Donald Trump's inauguration. He was at the deadly protest in Charlottesville last year and says he was not far behind Heather Heyer, the young woman who was hit by a car and killed.
I run up there and it looks like a war zone. People bleeding, screaming. They couldn't get ambulances through. It was a mess.
You say they're coming to these events looking for a fight, that they're armed, and they're ready.
Yeah.
So by giving it back to them, aren't you kind of playing into exactly what they're looking for?
The only other option is allowing them to attack the community. I'm not gonna stand back and do that. If people aren't gonna stand up to them, then they're going to grow. The same thing happened pre-World War II. And the next thing you know, 6 million dead Jews. Is it worth it? Yeah. To prevent another Holocaust? Absolutely. Are we on our way there? Yeah. Is there a civil war coming if we don't stop it?
Some people would see that as an extreme view.
Yeah, and so did people pre-World War II. And guess what? A lot of them were killed.
33-year-old Cameron is what you might call a reluctant Antifa member. He's a musician and an athletic trainer, and he represents what he says are a lot of Antifa protesters who aren't quite on board with all of the violence.
If you took violence out of the mix, wouldn't you still have the same platform?
Absolutely.
So, but why the need to fight?
For me personally, I can't speak for everyone and raises a flag for anti-fascist action, but for me personally, violence is only to be used as an absolute last resort. I try to sway people around me. I try to convince them, hey, don't just walk up and clock somebody on the street. That's not exactly great for optics. It's definitely an internal issue, and it's one that we're still fighting.
John Carrico believes violence is a tool that is necessary to Antifa. He's an anarchist who considers himself an activist, often starting his day at the food pantry.
Fritos, you want some Fritos? Here you go.
He also says he is running for the U.S. Senate in Tennessee.
I am more, you know, radical and like than that. Right. You know what I'm saying? So, but I'm not gonna run from that. I'm just using the platform. Move things further to the left.
Last summer, Carrico was arrested for fighting at a white supremacist gathering. He was charged with disorderly conduct, a misdemeanor. But the man he fought was so badly injured, he had to be evacuated by medical helicopter.
How did you land at anarchy?
I had been a big Obama supporter. He kind of let me down, so I was like, well, maybe the government isn't effective at doing these things.
John's father is a staunch Trump supporter who is appalled by his son's Antifa activities.
I'm not sure what Antifa or Antifa or how you pronounce it really is. I'm not sure that they're left. I mean, some people might lump them in with the supremacist group as far as, you know, as their methodology.
Would you?
Their methodology, I sure would. I think his methodology is just totally wrong. Well, who are you going to convince? The people in the middle? Well, no. Not really.
Right, and I don't think that what we're going for is public opinion, to be honest. I mean, I think what we're going for is the ability to stop. With the anti-fascist movement, it's about stopping fascism, whether or not it's popular to stop fascism.
98% of the people, or 99% of the people in this country are totally anti-fascist. You don't need an Antifa to stop fascism.
You think the threat's smaller?
I think the threat is almost non-existent.
But activists say their radical tactics are working.
I believe that we are shutting them down continually, making them afraid to organize because they don't want to be doxxed or they don't want to lose their jobs.
Hail Trump! Hail our people! Hail victory!
Even alt-right leader Richard Spencer, who organized many of the rallies that became violent, admits that Antifa's tactics have worked.
I really hate to say this, and I definitely hesitate to say this, but Antifa is winning to the extent that they are willing to go further than anyone else.
Case in point, a white supremacist rally planned last year in Murfreesboro, Tennessee, shut down the town. Businesses boarded up, fearing the worst. The group canceled at the last minute. A major victory for the Antifa.
What happened?
The Nazis canceled, apparently, the Murfreesboro rally. One of the organizers just put it on his Twitter.
Do you know why?
There's too many of us and not enough of them.
So doesn't this kind of prove the point that this can be accomplished without violence?
Sure, I mean, I think there's a diversity of tactics to be used. I think that we can try different things and different things work.
But this worked. The peaceful protests worked.
Mm-hmm. Sometimes.